Today's show is brought to you by Tula.com. Receive 20% off your entire purchase at www.trytula.com/313liveshow. For you, the listeners of the 313 Live Show, Tula is offering an opportunity to receive 20% off your entire purchase at Tula.com. To receive 20% off your entire purchase, go to trytula.com/313liveshow. Again, that's trytula.com/313liveshow to receive 20% off your entire purchase. Detroit City on the run and we ain't never gonna stop. The 313 Live Show, they got this thing wrong.
What up, dog?
Oh, my God. 313 Live. 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 313 Live. Oh, my God. 313 Live. Oh, my God. 313 Live. Oh, my God.
What's up, y'all? This is episode 44. We going into started to let you guys know that last week we was not gonna be recording anything live, and we are not doing anything live. But I did have to say this. We dropping Steezer's episodes right here that we did in the beginning of our podcast, even before we even released our very first recording. We got a lot of unreleased material that we said we just gonna release and just call it the unreleased tapes or the lost episodes of the 313 Live Show, and you know, sit back and enjoy it. We got some good shit for you. This one right here, we bringing in Angie. Angie was originally gonna be the third member of the 313 Live Show, but that didn't work out, and it wasn't in a bad manner that it didn't work out. Just, you know, creative differences between all three of us. And so, you know, she gracefully bowed out, and you know, you still got me and Doe Black here. And you know, this episode right here is just, you know, a taste of what it would have been like if we had a female, you know, putting her touch on it or whatever. And, you know, we got some other lost episodes that, you know, we're going to play along with this. So, you know, just sit back and enjoy yourself and have a Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. We'll see you. What's up, podcast world? We up in here, 313 Live. Got D Black in this motherfucker.
What up, though?
And we got a special co-host with us that may one day be permanently, and her name is Angie. Say hi to the podcast, Angie.
Hey.
So, Angie.
Yes?
Are you ready to hang with the big dogs in here? Because can't nobody really fuck with us.
I guess.
You guess. D, do you think that she can fuck with the big dogs up in here?
I guess.
Okay, y'all. Check game, people. We got a lot of shit for y'all going on. Hey, in the background, what y'all hear is Free Spirit. And we got the permission from Super Producer. Who is that J.street? We'll just say J.street. So, people, you heard Free Spirit in the last episode, and if y'all really like that song, I want y'all to email us at the 313liveshow@gmail.com and let us know what you think about it, and we will make sure that Janira and J.street gets your emails. So that's about it right now. We just really introducing Angie into the fold because she doesn't really know what she want to do. And, you know, she's going to be part-time a co-host full time, or she don't know what she want to do.
Sounds like that. Sounds like to me.
Sound like she don't really know what she want to do. So
we gotta get some. You know, we gotta.
You know,
some direction.
Yeah, we gotta get some direction from her.
What we gonna do?
We just gonna have some fucking fun. We gonna talk shit. That's what we gonna do.
We gonna talk some shit.
But first, right now, you know, we just wanna her to let everybody know who you are. You know, we wasting.
I like that. Big shout out to Janire and J.street.
Okay. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Detroit love. So, Angie.
What up, dog?
What's going on in your world today? You know, it's all good.
I'm good.
You good?
Until an hour ago when I lost my damn voice, but I'm good.
Angie, throw this horse, everybody, because she's been out deep throating.
Fuck you. Fuck you.
So, you know.
You hear this shit, girl?
She like,
what?
She does, you know, without it, got the wrong dick in her mouth, so, you know, she's in here fucked up. You know,
that's
shit.
That's so disrespectful.
Shit like that happens.
I hope some pussy get you locked, John.
It was a warm day. You probably got to always cover up.
You got to always cover up.
Your neck and stuff. Even if you give a neck, yeah, I can say, but... In this situation, I didn't mean to say it, but that's what we took it. I was just thinking about
you, man. You know,
in a scarf.
You know, when it's warm, man. When it's warm out, you know, you taking that warm shit down the throat.
Y'all can't be talking like this. You can get it shut down, seriously.
No, we're not gonna get shut down.
I hope y'all drown and squirt.
Well, people, stay tuned. We gonna come back in here and. We gonna give you some shit to talk about for real. You know, we sorry that.
Just that bullshit.
We ain't sorry. Fuck it. We really mean that shit. Is you sorry, D Black?
Hey man, I didn't even do nothing.
Yeah, me neither. You know,
I'm out of this. You
gonna die on coochie.
You know, you giving head.
Downplay this one.
You giving head. You giving head. And we don't say coochie on podcast. We say pussy. You know, we got the permission to say pussy. You know.
Motherfucker, I don't care what you say. I'm saying coochie.
Okay. Motherfuckers over here. Fellas.
That's what it's about, though.
Yeah, that's right. Fellas, we have our co-host is in this motherfucker throat fucked up, you know. Guess took one too far down the throat, fellas. So, you know, if y'all got something to say, fellas, about this shit, email us at the 313 Live Show on gmail.com, and you know the rest is history. Y'all, we're gonna talk about white people.
Oh my god.
Not in a bad way, but in a good way.
Let us pray.
Now, most white holy people, father. Let me tell you about white people. And this is real shit, right? White people
holy
are the some, type of people.
Some
not
people
some,
the white people you have met.
Not all, but some.
Okay. You
should have called them Caucasian, sir.
Okay, now.
This guy, yeah.
Some of the white people. Let me tell you, this is real shit.
Caucasians.
Now, y'all gotta shut the fuck up and let me say what I gotta say, okay?
Well, get the shit out.
Okay. Some white people, they like to hide shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, if motherfuckers is, your neighborhood had, just say, a massacre, and 3 days later, a fatal shooting and some rapings. White people, we don't want our community to look bad, so we're not going to share that with anybody. And now you got a whole set of new families moving into their community, right? So now the outsiders don't know what the fuck going on because the white people got the shit hid. Now you done bought your fucking house in their community. And then you find out weeks later that it was just a massacre and a couple killings and some pussy getting took in the neighborhood, right? But white people, I mean, you laughing, but I'm real. Come on, now tell the truth. You know some white people, not all white people, some white people, because I don't want to offend my white audience because I like white people and I got white neighbors and they cool with me. We
racist.
We don't know, not racist. We shake hands and we speak and shit, you know. But white people just got a total just difference with themselves. White, here we go. White versus black. Mm-hmm. Okay. White people hide shit.
black people, we tell shit. Bullshit. Okay. If there is a massacre on Iron Block and somebody took some pussy on Iron Block, we're going to call the news ourselves and give them the address and the location so the news crew could be there. Bullshit. Yeah. Come on, this is D fucking trade. This is not.
Them news folks got them damn scanners. They know what the hell going on. They look for shit in the hood.
Bullshit.
Yes, they do.
Okay.
I work for social media. I worked in the media business for 3.5 years. We look for that shit. They hide the white shit because they don't want you to think white folks is all that bad. Nigga shit is what they do.
Okay, make sure you speak in your mic because your volume low. It's low. I'm trying to work with you here. Go ahead, D-Black. What you say, my brother?
No, I was just saying, you say people don't be telling. Oh,
Not telling. We talking about in the community type shit. Okay.
And you say it's a lot of telling.
Not telling. Okay. This is what I'm saying is okay.
Are you referring to snitching?
No, not snitching.
That's what I'm saying.
That's what it sounds like.
Because I'm just saying it's hard in the black community. That's the problem. I be seeing they be having things up like neighborhood watch, right?
You mean grandma down the street?
Everybody, neighborhood watch, right?
Right,
Auntie Josephine.
No.
The neighborhood watch.
The whole neighborhood watch.
Everybody. You know how Detroit neighborhood is.
Goddamn right.
It started at the beginning of the block. You might have a weed house. In the middle of the block, you got a doctor. Uh-huh. It is halfway down the block. You got a college student.
Okay.
Down the block, you got two heroin spots. So.
Yes.
You know how Detroit is. So, but it's the neighborhood watch. Yes. One another.
Because
in the neighborhood in Detroit, we only got 2-3 malls, one mall,
right?
One market, 2-3 markets in every neighborhood, every gas station. Okay. So we all got to commute together.
You got there. Right.
So it's only amount of telling you gonna be telling. It's gonna be a lot of I told you so. I don't know about a lot of telling. I told your black ass before. Not to be going down 3/4 of the block at the 7. In Detroit, that's what I know that part. That's all I wanted to say about that, well, but I hear you.
You're right, because I remember back in my days of selling drugs, yeah. Narcotics. It was my crack spot. And there was like 3 other crack spots on the block.
Nigga in Detroit done sold some damn drugs.
I mean, yeah, everybody done sold drugs, but we had an alliance. That's what these young cats that they don't have is an alliance. I got my customers. You got your customers. Don't fuck with mine. That was how we got down back in the day. But now back to you white people.
Oh, my God.
I love you.
Oh, my God.
I swear I love you motherfuckers because you motherfuckers are so fucking funny at times. But I love you guys. Okay, like, a cop shoots and kill a black man, right?
Yeah.
A white motherfucker will say, hey, I saw that black guy attack the officer. Let's reverse the roles. If that was a nigga cop, a black cop, that shot a white kid dead, and that same white witness is gonna say, hey, that white kid was not doing a goddamn thing and that cop shot him. Now, we talking about this motherfucker, Stephen Rankins, police officer, somewhere up in Pennsylvania somewhere. Motherfucker, that's another day, another story. I'm still getting the facts together for that shit, but I'm going to hit y'all with that shit a little bit later, podcast. But we're going to go off into something else right quick. We get back with y'all. We just having some fucking fun tonight. We going off the head fucking with y'all. Okay, so
that's fun.
We gonna get with y'all in a minute. Give them something down to make them all bounce. Plan to add a couple more zeros to the account. Give them something down to make them all bounce. Plan to add a couple more zeros. Get the fiends what they fiendin' for. I'm the dopamine, nah, I'm it. I'm the Grinch, yeah, I'm meanin' by my green, that's just me. I pity all you fools, Mr. T. Hakuna Matata, all the haters worry me when the street blowin' through
through the cash, fast and furious. High boomerang back, got him curious. My dog, I do this here, make it look easy, but it's complex. Call me Lex Luger, baby, I'm a flex. Torture record lame on my back, drop him on the stack. Put him in a critical submission, tell him cut the check. Got a lot to lose, even more to gain, I'm here to step. Got no time to snooze, cause this paper ain't gon' make itself. Always into something, get it poppin', I'ma jump and check. In this line of scrimmage, I'ma get it, watch me run it back. When it comes to these dead presidents, we in the rack. Enemies my footstool, the world is my headrest. Yes.
Give them something, gotta make them all bounce. And they add a couple more zeros to your count. Give them something, gotta make them all bounce. And they add a couple more zeros to your count.
It's unexplainable. Respected everywhere that I go. Can say the same for you. A bark of us, we deep. I'm talking multitudes. Lean us some cheese. I'm showing you how the boss is moving. It's been a long time coming, finally here. Fake fellas where they shades. Don't want you to see they fear. I'm getting money, so call me the cashier. Burning rubber on them. This is a good year, yeah. I'm fresh out the Ziploc. Neck and wrist all rock. Whipped out the paint shop. Still drip drop. I see they like the plot. Keep the heat like a cop, give it to him to the side. Now that's real hip hop. D-boy fit it up till I'm body rock. Cohan dime on my feet, something you ain't got. They wanna download this one to their desktop, but I tell them, nah, homie, wait till that album drop.
Give them something, gotta make them all bounce. And they add a couple more zeros to the account. Give them something, gotta make them all bounce. And they add a couple more zeros to the account.
Tagging me, thanks for promo. Head to toe polo. With a man behind on the Lotto. Chain got me hunchback, Quasimodo. Still, I'm like, what up, though? The mitten man needed by the boatload. Show 'em what's fly, cause they dodos. Hating, that's a no-no. Ain't got time for these clowns, bozo. They trying their best to keep your boy loco. But I'm so global. Might just do a show down at Cobo. Then shoot a flight to Acapulco. They pray I lose my mojo. Keep it moving, I'll be on the go-go. Stacking up the day for tomorrow. Man, I need to put my coat on. Chocolate bone to keep me warm, I call her hot cocoa. She on me like my wardrobe. Fresh to death, but feeling so immortal. Keep something in the oven, DiGiorno, y'all know.
Give them something, gotta make them all bounce. And they add a couple more zeros to the account. Give them something, gotta make them all bounce. And they add a couple more zeros to the account.
White people, I apologize for that last segment if I offended some of you. Ooh, old, decrepit white motherfuckers. I frankly don't give a fuck if I offended the white old ones. But
racist.
You young white motherfuckers, I like y'all motherfuckers because y'all motherfuckers know how to party. Y'all act like black people, and I like you motherfuckers. Y'all get drunk, y'all smoke weed, and y'all fuck outside in cars and get head on the side of buildings. I love you guys.
Fucking freak.
Why I gotta be all that? Now, Mark, like speak, that. Angie. Speak. Why I gotta be all that? What's, you ain't never witnessed white people do that shit?
I mind my own goddamn business. That's what I do.
If I, honestly, I'm not gonna lie. If I walked up and I saw a car rocking, boom, 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 side to side, and I see a couple white motherfuckers in there going at it, I'm gonna stop and I'm gonna watch. I'm not gonna lie. I'm gonna fucking sit there and I'm gonna watch and see what the fuck is going on. I know what's going on. They fucking, but I'm just want to see is somebody satisfied and is somebody not satisfied. That's just who I am. I'm going to watch. What about you, dog?
Oh, you know what? I was just thinking. Have you ever seen that that van plate that says, if you see this van rocking, don't come a-knocking? You ever seen that?
Yeah, I saw that. But I'm not going to knock. I'm just going to watch. Funny, right? I'm just going to watch.
You ever done that? Get caught doing it? All right. public or something.
Oh. I did.
You did?
Yeah.
No, never.
Kept going.
I'm too smooth for that shit. Yeah, who caught you? The police?
Nah, motherfuckers down where he was at. I was on Belle Isle, first of all.
Ooh, you spot. Was fucking on Belle Isle?
For sure.
Was you asshole butt naked?
No.
No?
One leg, of course.
No, I wear dresses in the summertime.
Oh, you just look at your okay. Dress. About to wear dresses in the summertime? Okay. Dresses and no panties. Wow.
For sure.
If you are a lady out there and you are listening and you wear sang dresses in the summertime with no panties because you know you finna get boned, email us at the 313 Live Show. @gmail.com and subject it no panties. And Doe will answer all those no panty ones back quick. And I think Angie finna start some shit
here. Send a doctor's note with that shit.
Send a doctor's note, okay.
I just think you're supposed to keep your pussy covered at all times. I don't think you're supposed to have it exposed to the midnight mist.
How old are you, sir?
I'm old man, but I just don't think I don't have a pussy neither. But when you see the condition of some of them, you gotta blame it on something.
I like you. So you telling me you see a woman in the summertime with a sang dress on?
I don't think the pussy should be.
And she ain't got no panties on.
Pussy is covered.
Pussy's covered.
Just because she ain't got no drawers on, don't mean it ain't covered.
I don't know. I think she should be covered, bro.
Need to breathe.
I agree with her, but I don't really.
Breathe at home.
Unfortunately, at home it don't get to breathe because somebody's always trying to be up in it. So I'm gonna walk around with no drawers on.
Oh shit! You didn't see that one coming, did you?
No, I'm just
saying.
That bitch
need to breathe. She gets tired.
I'm just saying, my armpits need to breathe. I'm going out in public, I cover them with the deodorant.
Because you're going to be funky.
I'm saying the pussy bleed sweating too.
Wash your ass.
I don't think a woman with no drawers on sweat. Pussy sweat.
You ain't never smelled pussy on the bus or nothing?
Well, see, you like fish. No, I don't like no fishy, smelly pussy.
She's airing it out. She's calling it a free pussy. She's airing it out.
It's free pussy because she's airing it out.
No, it's not free. It's reasonable. Get your facts right.
It's reasonable pussy. See, now all women.
I don't know. I smelled it before.
You smelled pussy before on the bus?
I smell like fish.
That bitch is rank.
That bitch was there.
She needs to see a doctor.
Right? She always kept it covered.
And she probably did have panties on. I'm sure she had a discharge on top of that.
That's what I'm saying. How you live that life?
Because a motherfucker don't care.
That's what I'm saying.
I'm lost.
There's some stank balls out here too now.
I wouldn't know.
Stank balls.
I wouldn't know.
Stanky,
sweaty, nasty balls.
We got a house full of people in here tonight, and we doing this shit.
We don't
want
to smell that shit either. Take them drawers off and let them breathe. Whoosh. Them motherfuckers need to breathe, lift, and spread, goddammit. Shit.
I don't have no idea what the fuck
be stanking like a
talking
mama.
About. You pay them no attention. You pay that microphone attention to what we talking about over here.
But she's right. Yeah, I know. Lost for words, ain't you?
I don't have stank balls.
I don't have stank balls myself either. But,
I feel sorry for you women that ran into them.
So hold on, hold on.
When the last time you washed your penis?
Every day.
No, when's the last time?
You can smell it right now.
God damn it, I'm sure.
You can smell it right now, and I guarantee you it smell like black soap and shea butter. I guarantee. If you get your dick sucked as much as mine, you know. It's shaved, ain't no hair on my ass, or none of that.
Okay. Hey, okay.
All that's because you get as much head as I do.
I love too much.
You ready? ready. I live that life. I know I might want my shit. Dick out at any time.
That's what I'm talking about.
It's not.
I want right
and the smell of it is not going to turn you away.
I think you turned on about your own smell, though.
Supposed to be. Supposed to be. Don't nobody smell they self? I'm at home and by myself, I smell my ass. So where we been? I smell my ass. Oh, this ass ain't right. Let me go take care of this. I don't just sit at the house and just chill. I be smelling. Let me check. Oh, this shit done wore off. Let me go take care of me. I thought everybody did that. I look at my toenail. Let me get this shit up out of here. Y'all motherfuckers just go at home and just relax. Wake up.
Everyone is not like you.
I thought everybody did this
shit. No, Daddy. Everybody ain't like you.
All right, now, Angie. Let me ask you a question.
I look at my past like, I do that shit. I do that shit.
Hold on a second, Angie. So you mean to tell me you was in the process of once upon a time about to give a nigga some head and the balls was musty?
Man.
Honestly? Have you?
What is that
kind of
me?
But no, you co-hosting.
This is some bullshit. Only female on the panel. I got to always get the point.
Goddamn
the
right. Point. That's what you're here for. So now. So you mean to tell me you was giving some head once upon a time?
Nigga, I ain't never said I was giving head when I said sweaty balls.
Okay, but we just asked.
I pulls the balls out.
You pulls the balls
out. I plays with it.
You plays with the balls.
I get him ready.
You get him ready.
I do the sniff test like you motherfuckers do. Okay. Dip and sniff? That's me, goddammit.
Dip and sniff? Okay,
shit, so I got to know it's right.
You got to know it's right? Okay.
Good.
Okay, have you ever ran into a nigga that his shit was not right?
Yes.
And what did you tell him when, you know, the balls was funky? Seriously, what did you tell him? I think we got her on the ropes with this one, but...
I told that nigga that Dove, Irish Spring... Lever 3000, 2000, whatever. All Soaps was his friend, and he need to become friends, like, real fast. I ain't fucked with him since.
Yeah. Yikes. Not yeah. D. Yeah. Have you been able to get ready to eat some pussy, and the pussy smelled horrible? Tell the truth, I was getting ready to fuck, and the pussy was stunk. The truth shall set you free, my brother.
Okay, first off. I don't want my pussy smelling too clean.
My nigga.
No, I want it like it's like a sweet type of musk it's got to have.
Goddamn
go
musky
right.
Little
go
bit.
On, Plies.
Just a little bit.
Just a little musk.
Right.
Goddamn okay. Right.
You got your sweet pussy salad too.
Yeah. Yeah, like that. But other than that, I ran into somebody like, but as soon as you take the slip off, you gonna run, bro. If you go through that, you just desperate.
Yikes.
It's horrible.
I've never ran into no pussy like that, but I have ran into, like I told you, Alabama.
But people
got
say,
the worst
but
pussy.
That's when the girl is sick. Man. I don't understand why they just don't take care of themselves. But that's what I'm saying. Why people don't smell themselves? Why I'm the only one smelling myself? This
so
is stupid.
Do we need to go to Health 101 real fast?
This is so fucking weird, right? I'm the only one smell themselves.
So you really digging your ass?
When yes,
you
constantly.
Really?
That's how I know. I'm guaranteed I'll win that bet right now, my. Balls smell like shea butter. It's motherfucking black soap. I done checked it.
Please, go check his balls.
Okay.
I got my legs cocked over there. Got my legs cocked
now. Check
balls. Okay, now, his balls.
I don't believe it.
Smell
nobody
like
does
black
it.
Soap and
you
shea butter.
Uh-oh. You're not alone.
Okay.
Man. I ain't that no. I know, right? Goddamn. Don't be telling me that shit.
Okay, okay.
Make me look weird.
Okay.
For one, I'm a big girl. I got to make sure she right.
What I'm talking about. See?
Okay. I washed my ass before I came here. What the fuck? You never know what the fuck is going to happen.
Okay, no.
People don't know that. That's a real thing about hygiene. People don't know about their hygiene. They don't.
Okay.
They don't
now,
know that shit.
Now, fellas and
you
ladies.
See, they do, but they don't. They don't know.
Hold on now, to you fellas and ladies out there in the podcast world. Ladies, if you ran across a nigga that had some funky nuts when you was ready to suck his dick, and fellas, you ran across some funky pussy when you was ready to eat it or stick it, we want y'all to hit us up at the 313 Live Show at gmail.com and title that Bad Hygiene. You know what I'm saying? Bad hygiene and We're going to read some of your emails over the fucking air. And, you know, if you get lucky, we might call your motherfucking ass in and give you a Detroit hat or something to let you know that, hey, thanks for listening to us. Or we might have Doe come over there and fuck your old lady.
Nah, don't put me on front. He a lie. The truth ain't in.
So, Doe, if it was a fine-ass woman, you wouldn't bang her?
Sir, I just slept with twin sisters.
Okay.
In the future, sir.
Okay.
Real life.
Okay, I know that, sir.
That's what I'm saying.
We'll talk about that on the next segment. That's what I'm saying, bro. Segment. We're going to talk about that on the next segment. He's a freak.
What's your number?
There ain't a killer in this city, I don't know. Therefore, it ain't a motherfucking place I can't go. Bitch, I'm everywhere. I'm everywhere. I'm everywhere. I'm everywhere. I got more guns than the motherfucking stove. So why the fuck would I ever be scared of you, foe? Bitch, I'm everywhere. I'm everywhere. I'm everywhere. I'm everywhere. You can catch me drinking goose on my front porch, even when the hood hot. When I'm in Flint, I feel like every block is my block. I ain't scared of man, nigga. I go where the fuck I wanna go. Any restaurant, gas station, or motherfucking store. Riding with my baby brother, Crown Vicin' on them 24. After our nightclubs, ho niggas, we saying no. Just say you're looking for me, let me tell you where I'm at. Worked at the Dayton store, drinking with my pistol on my lap. I'm up in every bitch house like a pallet on the floor. Man, I told you once before, there ain't a place I can't go. Any city, any town, I done been around the. And can't nay a nigga ever say it, play me like a hoe. I ain't playing with your hoe, fuck with me, you're getting shot. Or either slap with a pistol while the barrel still hot. Duck tape your whole family, take everything they got. I ain't never had a problem with running in nigga spots. There ain't a killer in this city, I don't know. Therefore it ain't a motherfucking place I can't go. Bitch, I'm everywhere. I'm everywhere. I'm everywhere. I'm everywhere. More guns than the motherfucking stove. So why the fuck would I ever be scared of you, foe? Bitch, I'm everywhere. I'm everywhere. I'm everywhere. I'm everywhere. Where we live is like a wilderness, and bitch, I'm a bear. I'm every motherfucking where, just like a table and chair. And you ain't never where we at, you know it's killers in there. They stay high on every narcotic drug dealers can spare. Right here in Flint, bitch, we act stupid about the clothes that we wear. Kohans and Gucci's that will shoot you if you step on a pair. I'm off the mollies and that gas, I'm turned up in this bitch. Walk in the club, these bitches double dutch and jump in my dick. And don't get caught up in that gossip, boy, thinking you're slick. All on Facebook, beefing, acting just like a chick. And fuck them skinny jeans, tight shirts, sweaters, and vests. Walking around this bitch looking like you're squeezing your chest. All these commercial MCs, the rap games in distress. I know Ice Cube watching BET, not feeling depressed. I'm from that Ice T, Snoop Dogg, slap a bitch, error. Rest in peace, Pimp C, holla church for Jacob Fella. There ain't a killer in this city, I don't know. Therefore it ain't a motherfucking place I can't go. Bitch, I'm everywhere. I'm everywhere. I'm everywhere. I'm everywhere. I got more guns than the motherfucking stove. So why the fuck would I ever be scared of you, foe? Bitch, I'm everywhere. I'm everywhere. I'm everywhere. I'm everywhere. I'm in Mona's out on the patio. Damn, I miss Arlene. I'm in the D at Club Blue with a bankroll in my jeans. In the palm tree on Friday. Lux Lounge the next day. Raspberries on Thursday. C Club, you heard me? After two, the van club. Boogie down in the drifter. Cloud nine, the Odyssey. Street riders, I'm fucking with. She's up to what's next. Out of towners know not to flex. Flip Michigan as a whole. We known to die for respect. There ain't a killer in this city, I don't know. Therefore, it ain't a motherfucking place I can't go. Bitch, I'm everywhere. I'm everywhere. I'm everywhere. I'm everywhere. I got more guns than the motherfucking stove. So why the fuck would I ever be scared of you, foe? Bitch, I'm everywhere. I'm everywhere. I'm everywhere. I'm everywhere.
We're going to talk about the White House and Hillary Clinton and Bill Clinton. Okay.
She couldn't
Hillary
keep them down
and Bill Clinton. This is what we finna do, y'all. Okay, real fucking talk. Okay, now we all know that Bill liked getting his dick sucked in the White House, right? He was on the phone. Monica. Yeah, he was jacking off with Monica Lewinsky, had phone sex, and it was a lot of recordings behind that shit, right? So if Bill liked this shit from other women, you know that Hillary is sucking his dick.
No, she's not. She eats coochie.
Hillary's pussy? Well, Hillary Clinton, if you're listening to my podcast, you are okay with the 313 Live Show crew because, you know, you suck pussy allegedly. But I know that Bill like getting his dick sucked and you his wife, so I know that you sucking his dick. I always wondered after watching Monica Lewinsky, do Hillary spit or swallow when she's sucking Bill's dick? I always wanted to know that. What would you think, though? Do you think she's a spitter or a swallower?
I don't know if I ever said this again. I don't know if I said this before.
Right.
But, like, we was talking about this at the club. But I'm going to just say it, though. I don't like slobbers. A slobber.
You don't like a slobber?
Yeah. Like, yeah.
The sound effects are being made by Angie, everybody, and Angie is a dick sucker. Allegedly, he's a dick sucker. Well, I'm not gonna say allegedly shit. She says she sucks dicks, and she sucks dick. But back at Hillary,
shit, I'm a grown ass woman.
Okay, to me, Hillary,
you about to get cussed the fuck out?
Hold looks on. Like Hillary looks like she can do some shit in the bed. That's all I'm just gonna say.
You think she freaky diggy?
Honestly,
Hillary looks sexy to you?
She look a little sexy.
Oh no,
she look a little sexy. You know when I bet you get a couple drinks up in you, should be sexy too. If she said, "Come here, though, whip out your dick,"
mm-hmm. She's gonna be in control.
You gotta have control.
You
dog.
Got to, man. Live this life.
Okay, let me ask you a question. If Monica Lewinsky walked in this room right now and said she was ready to give you some head, you wouldn't let Monica Lewinsky suck your dick?
Yeah, black soap and shea butter.
Yeah, black soap and shea butter. You wouldn't let Monica Lewinsky suck your dick? Because you said, now, quote, unquote, your words, I am all about that life and I am always ready.
No, yeah, but I'll probably say no. It's on my terms, though.
Get the fuck out of here.
It's on my terms. I make it. It's on my
lies.
Terms.
Lies.
It's on my terms. I'm a
lies,
boss.
You tell.
It's on my
time. Why does it have to be on your time?
It makes it better. It makes you more like, hey, it's going like how I like it, not how you want it. Control, right. You got to always keep your position, man. It's fun. It's better that way for me.
So you like a woman to really submit to you.
Yeah, a submit. Yeah, I want to see that submission.
So you telling me that?
I want to see that cry, yeah. I want to see that.
So
yeah,
she has
I want to see that.
She has to submit to you.
Yeah, I like that.
What kind of bullshit is
it
this?
It works, though, bro.
It works. Okay, now.
Gotta commit, though.
You gotta commit. Okay, now. To me, just me saying me, honestly, as the man that I am, I think, though, for real, if Monica Lewinsky was in this room right now, and dropped on her knees, and when nobody here but you, you would let Monica Lewinsky suck your dick. Now, quit bullshitting.
Probably because if there was nobody here, I would probably be chilling, D. I ain't doing shit. I'd go here and get my dick sucked because I ain't doing shit. But at this,
here's
that's
the truth,
different.
Everybody.
I ain't
here's
doing shit,
room.
But smelling my ass, dog, like shit. I'm smelling my ass.
No,
you walk in, wash your dick sucked. All right, fuck
soap.
It. Okay.
Get it.
All right, cool. That's different. The scene was different.
The scene is different. Okay, yeah. You chilling by yourself. Monica Lewinsky walked through this door and said, "I'm gonna suck your dick. Nobody's here. You're gonna drop down." Okay.
Oh, I ain't got shit else to do.
Shit else. Okay, so right now, Secret Service pull up. Just you here by yourself.
Oh my.
And say, "Mr. Doe Black, the First Lady Hillary Clinton wants to speak to you. We're gonna pull this car all the way in the driveway and we're gonna step in the front." And Hillary say I'm gonna get you some head. You telling me you're not gonna take none of that great presidential head?
I'm not saying I wouldn't. I'm not saying. I'm just saying. Mm-hmm. If the timing is good, then it's right.
Mm-hmm. Timing is good.
I'm an older person. I ain't young and shit. I run. I don't know how I dig more. Bitch, I got basic. I did my push-ups and all that shit. Ain't right and everything.
But now,
bitch might have called me out and had half a lunch or something. I can't do shit no way.
All right, check game, people.
Nah. Bitch, he called me out about 20 or something. But it's different.
Now check game, Pete Move. Check game, Pete Move, everybody. Okay, just say for instance. Now, you seen Donald Trump, right? Put him in the pills. You take one of the Viagra.
Cialis.
Okay. I can't even do the whistle. God damn.
Now, this question for you, Angie. Angie. This is for you. Okay, Angie.
What?
If Donald Trump pulled in right now and said, I got a cool $100,000 for you right now to suck my dick, would you suck Donald Trump's dick right now for that $100,000?
Fuck yeah, I'm in debt.
Fuck yeah, I'm in debt.
Why she get money, though? I didn't get offered any money. Okay, cool. All right, double standards. All right. Okay. Just because I'm a dude, I'm going to do it just because it's tripped up. That's okay. Cool, though. That's right. Ain't no problem. All
right, real talk. Here's, the real shit is this, okay?
Shit, I need to pay my car.
Have you seen? Right? It's a no-brainer.
Donald Trump's wife. Now, Trump got a nice-looking wife, okay? You know he paid for the ass and paid for her titties and pay for that young
white women
face.
Don't have ass.
Yeah, but no, he paid for that ass. That's what I'm saying.
Oh, he paid for it literally. Oh, gotcha.
Yeah, paid literally to get an ass. You know, ass job. If Donald Trump got a wife this motherfucker fine, why in the fuck did his hair look like a gang of cats licked his shit to the side?
You didn't know he really liked that?
I've been
he likes that hairdo.
I see that shit, man. Go ball. Let this shit go. It's time to let it go.
You think it's bad luck, bro?
He done had that carpet for how long?
I think he got his first. Something he made a big deal, man.
Had that damn carpet.
Yeah.
Well, listen, real talk. If that's the president of the United States that we're gonna have running our country, I'm going to Canada, Mexico. Real fucking talk. I'm getting the fuck up out of here because now, how you gonna let Obama leave office with swag? A president got swag and all together and like, fuck you motherfuckers, you know what I'm saying, in a nice way.
This ain't the first time.
And bring this motherfucker, flea bag ass motherfucker in here with this hair style of like, a bunch of alley cats out of Detroit done got together and licked his fucking head off.
Angie, you say this ain't the first time.
Clinton. Bill has swag. He might have been a white man, but he has swag.
Bill is considered a nigga because he was getting pussy in the White House.
Wait a minute.
Bill was getting pussy in the White House, so he all right with me.
So, did y'all want to see Bill back, though? Don't people want to see him back?
I would love to see Bill.
He'd be the first man, right? Or something like that. How'd that go? If we have a woman president. What'd that make Bill?
Bill would be the first husband.
The first husband?
Yeah, he'd be the first husband. You know, he would be the bitch. He would play the bitch role.
Ah, shit.
Bill would play the bitch role, for real. But ain't nothing wrong with that shit. Your wife, the president, you was the president. Now you can get some more pussy in the White House when she out of town. Get the fuck out of here.
No.
Who wouldn't love that job?
I won't.
I would love playing the bitch role that Bill is going to play.
Bill always going to have more money than us.
You say that again to the people in podcast?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Bill going to always have more money?
Yeah, because he was already in politics before.
Yes.
Wasn't that in Arkansas?
Yeah.
So he was already in them six figures back then. So he still got the stipend from being a president.
So
and still making money because he got all them nonprofits and shit.
He
gonna be a paid ass bitch though.
So Angie, if Bill Clinton walked in here right now and said, "Hey Angie, can I get these and suck my dick?"
Why I got to always suck the dick? Can I fuck? Damn, the pussy like to get banged. I'm sorry.
Okay, not bad.
Damn.
I think you need some head or something. Damn, let
shit.
It go. Oh, let
shit.
It go.
Oh, okay, y'all.
getting serious.
This shit is getting serious. Okay, we getting serious up in here.
Shit, can Bill come just eat the pussy? Shit.
One time. They don't talk about Bill doing that shit.
Nah, Bill don't eat pussy. I don't think. Well, he probably eat Hillary's pussy, but that's about it.
He eating that ass like groceries.
All right, people. We gonna wrap this down, and we gonna come back with some more shit in a minute.
What's up, podcast? As I was stating earlier on, this is one of the lost episodes that we never released. And matter of fact, I believe that this was going to be episode 2. We had recorded this episode back in, I want to say, early February of 2016. Like I said, before we even ran our very first podcast, if you can really sit back and you can listen to it, and you heard us in the beginning claim that can't nobody fuck with us. And, you know, we wasn't even on podcast yet, and we didn't even have the audience that we have now. And we was letting everybody know that we was coming through the dough and wasn't nobody going to be able to fuck with us. And we made good with that. Ain't nobody going to fuck with us, and we holding our ground down. I want to say what's up to Mexico, Virginia, New York, Texas, Alabama, even though I said they women got some of the worst pussy I ever had in the world, Alabama listens and tune in faithfully. Ohio, Michigan, Pennsylvania, California. Cali's been giving us mad love for the longest. They've been with us from day one, and they still with us and rocking and rolling with us. Vegas is with us. What should I say? Nevada. My bad. Canada fucks with us tough. They've always been fucking with us. And the UK. The UK, we got a lot of strong support and listeners over there in the UK. If you're listening to this episode on SoundCloud, stop. We don't fuck with SoundCloud like that. Because SoundCloud does not count our downloads in the main menu over here with the distributor. So y'all can start listening to us direct on iHeartRadio, iTunes, Podbean, Stitcher Radio app, TuneIn Radio app, Overcast FM, and what's that? Google Play Music. You can hear us all over there on those spots where a podcast is at. SoundCloud, we not really fucking with SoundCloud. I repeat, we're not really fucking with SoundCloud. I'm going to release this episode over on SoundCloud, and that's it. And you know where you got to go. iHeartRadio, iTunes, Stitcher Radio app, TuneIn, Podbean, Google Play, Overcast FM. Shit, go wherever podcast is at, we going to be there except SoundCloud and Podomatic. We not fucking with Podomatic either. But we here. We'll see y'all next year. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year's. Everybody, listen to me. If you're going to be getting some pussy for the New Year's and some pussy for Christmas, please go over and listen to our episode where you can tune in on Red Roof In. You go log in and sign in and use our username /the313live show and you know, get some pussy on us. We're going to get you some money off your room. So go over there and use that room. Matter of fact, I'm going to put that drop on right now after we leave so I can tell you where to go, how to get there, and tune in. Like I said, if you're getting pussy, I know a lot of people are going to get some pussy for Christmas Day after Christmas, New Year's, and you go on the Red Roof and treat yourself on the 313 Live Show. You're going to get a percentage off of your room to go in there and fuck. You know what I'm saying? Just go there, log in, sign, you know, make your reservations. And while you're busting a nut, you're busting a nut and you're saving some money. Peace and love, and we'll see you on January 3rd. We out of here. Today's show is brought to you by RedRoof.com. Receive 10% off your Red Roof In stay at www.stayatredroof.com/313. 313 Live Show. For you, the listeners of the 313 Live Show, Red Roof is offering an opportunity to receive 10% off your stay at redroof.com. To receive your 10% off your stay at Red Roof Inn, go to stayatredroof.com/313 Live Show. Again, that's stayatredroof.com/313 Live Show to receive your 10% off.